herds of small boar-like creatures called javelinas are wreaking havoc on a golf course. That's right, a golf course in Sedona, Arizona, and they're not slowing down. This is a Seven Canyons golf course. It's located in the Coconino National Forest, which is, to be fair, a natural habitat of the javelinas. But M. Casey, who is assistant superintendent of that golf course, has been engaged in this weeks-long battle with the herds. Here's some video that she took of what they're doing to that golf course. So as you can see, just completely wrecked, like green that's been snouted up. I don't know how else to say this, but just they're having a party. So there's like little pockets of mud if you're listening as a podcast, and yeah, that's, you cannot play golf on that. Who and what and why are javelinas? They're herbivorous. How do you say that, Jake? Herbivorous. I don't know. Herbivorous javelinas, also known as collared peccary, have been rampaging through the green at night, digging up large swaths of the grass in an apparent quest for food. M. Casey said that there is about 4 or 5 herds that go through, that are surrounding the golf course, about 100 or 150 javelinas in total. And she posted these photos. Again, it's gorgeous in Sedona. I feel like the golf course kind of effing up the vision, if you want to ask my honest opinion. She said they've been spending like 50 hours a week cleaning up the mess. But you know what? You know who's not mad at this? Twitter. That's right. Twitter has taken the side of the javelinas in this epic battle, golf course v javelina. Here's just a few supportive tweets. Kisses make me boogie. O'Lantern tweeted, "I just looked up javelina, and let me tell you, golf is not winning a PR war against these guys." With a very cute little image of a little baby javelina who's so little sweet, so cute. And then Alexander Avina writes, "Javelinas have started the eco revolution in Arizona." And Dino Dad Reviews tweeted, "The orcas have opened a second front by allying with the javelinas." That's obviously in reference to orcas sinking yachts. To say nothing of also, what else? The seals, the otters have been rising up. Cenk, there's a new attempt, however, to get rid of them. This is cruel. This is from M again, M. Casey, who's the superintendent there, assistant superintendent, tweeted this photo of her, of what she bought. She said, "This is the latest attempt to get rid of them. 1 million Scoville unit chili oil. We plan to test it out on a small patch of turf this week to see if it causes any damage. If not, it's go time." I don't know what that means, like if they didn't die. Apparently it didn't work. She posted this video and she said, yeah, no, there's, it's, yeah. I think the video we saw, it hasn't worked. And I just think that's rude. I feel like, what is she gonna do? Like put out the hot chip? Like is she gonna give the javelinas the hot chip challenge and hope they like never come back to the grass? No, yeah. They're boars. They love that chili oil.
Yeah, it's definitely not gonna work. So first, I feel like this is a new series we have at TYT. Animals versus humans. Let's play the next round. Yeah, we did the orca story. We did a whole bunch. We did like 3 or 4 of these. And now the javelinas. Or the very dirty sounding collared peccaries. Okay, hey, let's not just gloss by that. That is a hilarious name for an animal. Anyways, there they go, the collared peccaries. I like that the golfers are like, "I can't believe they're screwing up our golf course, okay? They have no business here." And the javelinas are like, "I got news for you, brother. This was ours first. And we don't realize it's a golf course because we're not human. It just looks like delicious grass to us." And then when you put the chili sauce on it, we're like, they have flavored grass here. We love it. Guys, they're boars. Boars eat humans. Boars will eat anything. Okay, chili. You thought you were gonna get them with that. Okay, no. So look, it's nearly impossible not to root for the cutie little animals. Although, in the beginning, when I saw this without seeing the video first, And then when I saw the video, I was like, oh yeah, no, they did some damage to that golf course. Yeah. I thought it was like a small thing and people were like, oh, the animals, why do they exist? Why can't we wipe them all out, right? But then when I saw the golf course, I was like, no, it's a war. Yeah, I get it. And right now the Javelinas are winning. So look, easy for me to root for them. I don't play golf there, okay? But those Javelinas, now that I saw the damage that they did, they're not playing. And apparently no. Neither are the golfers.
Not at all. I mean, it's just boohoo. I'm sorry. Like boohoo, your stupid golf course. You spend way too much water to grow that grass. And then what do you do every day? You mow it down. What a waste of water for honestly a really boring sport. No offense, Cenk. But I will say that what's interesting about this story, notice that it is in Arizona, right? Whereas you've got feral hogs over in Texas. And what do they do with feral hogs in Texas? They shoot them from helicopters, just gun them down because the feral hogs are like, I guess, taking over large swaths of Texas. And it's legal because it's Texas to just straight up gun them down. You can do that. You can buy a ticket to use a machine gun on feral hogs, which is just so unthinkably awful. Like, I don't know, whatever happened to glue traps? You know what I mean?
It's like the most right wing thing. And I know there's hunters that are totally left wing and moderates. That's hunting is not that. But this kind of like Rambo hunting, so it's got like the Trump kids written all over it. Like no actual like preparation and skill and all the things that a hunter needs. They're just like, yo, dude, we're on a copter. Oh, look, they look so cute. Let's kill them all. Okay, so look, guys, the bottom line is, I mean, I keep going. I can tell you about how I think that the animals, remember when they all came out during COVID? And they're like, yes. Oh my God, the humans have left. This is amazing. Let's reclaim the planet, right? And then when we came back, they're like, oh, damn it. So I think this is them striking back a little bit. But once we get beyond that, in all seriousness, this is they're so cute when they're babies.
They're so cute.
This is the conundrum that we've had ever since us human apes came out of Africa. What do we do with the rest of animals? A lot of them bother us. The rats, they spread disease, the mosquitoes, pain in the ass. Flies, no one likes them, okay? And sometimes feral hogs will mess you up. So we kill a lot of them, but then we feel bad about it. That's just reality.
God, we took a really serious turn here, but like this is what leads to things like COVID-19, right? And these SARS, whatever outbreaks, like is the fact that we are treading on like native, you know, animal land that isn't ours, more and more development, unnecessary things like golf courses. I'm not saying the Javelinas like carry the next, you know, pandemic, but who knows? Maybe they do. Something weird happens and like, you know, the next pandemic makes us all like really bad golfers or something. Like, I feel like this is, you know, the humans, this is what all the animal rights folks are like, humans are the actual plague. We know this. The Javelinas were here first. And so I get why, you know, in a way, all these animals are like giving us our little like, you know, our sort of little like animal Che Guevara's. Like these are the animal revolutionaries that we identify with because we're like, they're just doing what animals do. They eating the grass and they're, but oops, class war. Oops, we did a class war. I want to throw up this tweet because it's true that over in Argentina, they have all these like private gated neighborhoods, right? And they're like pristine and blah, blah, blah. But they're eating up a bunch of wetlands. They're eating up a bunch of like, you know, again, native animal land. And one of those animals is the capybara. And so this is someone on Twitter reminding us that as people rally behind the Javelinas, I ask you to not forget the brave class warriors who came before them. The capybaras. I would say capybaras, not as cute as the Javelinas, but all they're kind of like cats and squirrel. If a cat and a squirrel got together, I'd have to pet them. Thank you so much, producers, for this. I would have to pet each one, the Javelina and the capybara, to know which one I like more.
That's so fair. You know, that's why I've always thought you're one of the fairest people on the internet, Franny.
Thank you.
you know, just to be, yeah. So, and I like how you threw me under the bus on golf for no reason, like as if I'm like some sort of
fancy. I thought you said you like it.
No, I used to play pitch and putt like a decade ago, okay?
Oh, okay.
I played two rounds of golf. No, I don't mind golf. I wish I had time for golf, but I'm not gonna choose golf over.
It's like a 5 hours of your day.
Oh yeah, you know me, I got no time for that. I mean, I wish I did, but I don't. Anyways.
You're not up to anything big, right?
Oh no, no, never. So, but look, I like these rebels. I like that they're you know, saying enough of these goddamn humans. The flip side is that I'm a humanist. I'm for the humans, and I get attacked from the left and the right for that, because the right's like, no, secular humanist is terrible. I don't understand who the right wing's for if they're not for the humans. They're definitely not for the animals either. So I don't know who they're for. But some on the left will say, no, the animals deserve the land instead. Yeah, I hear you. I hear you. Don't gratuitously kill anybody. But on the other hand, if you've got a wild boar charging towards my kids, I'm gonna take that son of a gun out. Okay, I'm a humanist. Okay, I'm just keeping it real. And finally, I like we'll do a collabo on this name, Franny, because you mentioned that they're
okay.
The Che Guevara of the animal kingdom. So I guess they would be Javelinas.
Yes, the Javelina.
Yeah. So I am
Groundhog Guevaras.
Oh, something. Okay.
We'll workshop it.
We'll workshop. But I look, bottom line on this particular controversy, even though I'm a humanist, no, I gotta root for the Javelinas. They're too cute, they're too rebellious, they're too Young Turks. I like them.
Aww.
I vote for them.
Hey, thanks for watching that video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members, because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us, become a Young Turk.